There go the judge. There go the judge.
Kidala set at 99.9 megacycles. You're listening to the FM Sounds and Music. In the closing portion of this 55-minute segment of the FM Sounds and Music, you heard Al Keoha's electric guitar, Stay a While, and the music of Simon and Garfunkel as played by the Sound Symposium, The Dangling Conversation. We'll be back in just 5 minutes on a Sunday morning following the news. Your dial is set at 99.9 megacycles on your FM band. This is AFVN-FM, broadcasting from Saigon. The time of the tone, 1000 hours.
Headlining this hour's news, the first new Pura sessions end and California mudslides take 11 lives. Good morning. I'm Army Specialist Gary W. Gears.
AFVN, news on the hour, compiled from major American networks, wire services, and military sources. Now, complete details.
The news in Paris, the first formal session, the peace talks is over, and correspondent Bill Butel is there.
As the first session of the substantive peace talks here in Paris broke up after 6.5 hours of negotiation, all the four participants in the talks seemed content, at least, with what had happened inside the old Hotel Majestic. If the length of meetings means anything, and usually it's considered that it does mean something, then the meeting today was probably a qualified success. Henry Cabot Lodge told us that he asked the North Vietnamese and the NLF that the DMZ, the demilitarized zone between North and South Vietnam, be reestablished. There was no reaction to that suggestion inside the meeting, but afterwards the North Vietnamese spokesman told us that North Vietnam already has rejected this idea because they think it's a smokescreen for American aggression. This does not mean, of course, that they will reject it as the talks go on.
And Ambassador Lodge also said he was ready to work out a plan whereby all foreign troops could be withdrawn from Vietnam. There was a lot of discussion on the shape of the bargaining table in Paris in the beginning, but not too much was ever said about the hall itself when the talks are held. Correspondent Bernard Redmond has that story.
It's the full dress opening of the Paris Conference on Vietnam. I'm speaking from the Grand Ballroom of the International Conference Center, the old Hotel Majestic, on the Avenue Kléber near the Arch of Triumph. This 60-year-old, six-story building was once Nazi military headquarters and then U.S. military headquarters. UNESCO used it, then the French Foreign Ministry took it over for conferences. By a curious coincidence, the first conference held here was on Franco-Vietnamese affairs in 1946. Outside are chestnut trees along the sedate avenue of business and residential buildings. This ballroom is about the size of a tennis court. The decoration is rather rococo. Gold sculptured gray walls with inset marble medallions, three glittering crystal chandeliers, and on opposite walls, two Gobelin tapestries representing Diana the Huntress with doves at the top. And I can see in the corners of the ceiling, glowering hawks or American bald eagles. This is Bernard Redmont at the Vietnam Conference in Paris.
No relief is in sight in Southern California, where mudslides and floods have taken 11 lives and have done at least $5 billion in damages. The weatherman forecasts rain continuing through tomorrow. The victims were buried alive, with rivers of mud rolled down from foothills already soaked by more than 1 week of rain. Police report hundreds of houses have been destroyed or badly damaged. 26 railroad cars carrying butane fuel derailed today at Laurel, Mississippi. 16 of them blew up in a series of explosions that made a shambles of a 10-block area. At least 39 persons were injured and 30 homes destroyed in the explosions and fires. One 12-year-old girl is reported missing. It was the third such derailment in as many weeks involving the same Southern Railway train, number 154. Federal investigators are looking into that series of derailments. Secret testimony went on at the Naval Court of Inquiry about the loss of the Pueblo today. Skipper Lloyd Booker talked about the intelligence ship's mission and operation. Two of their witnesses also testified. All their testimony was marked classified and not released. Other Navy officers are expected to testify about the decision not to send air aid to the Pueblo, but it was surrounded by North Korean ships. In Santa Barbara, California, experts from the United States and Japan are stunning policy toward Red China. ABC correspondent Bill Brannigan is at the conference, and Brannigan says
there seems to be a new wave of movement toward trying to establish some sort of normal relations with Peking rather than the present isolated status of relations that Washington and Peking maintain.
Now that's from correspondent Bill Brannigan in Santa Barbara, California. The chief prosecutor in the trial of Clay Shaw, New Orleans, dropped a strong hint today. It was that he'll ask the jury to believe that the assassin of President Kennedy was not Lee Harvey Oswald. Assistant District Attorney James Alcock did the hinting while questioning a prospective juror. After 5 days, only 8 men have been picked to hear the state's conspiracy case against Shaw. Today's session was held in hopes of completing the jury, but no new names were added to the jury rolls. And that's latest news to the hour, compiled from major American networks, wire services, and military sources. I'm Army Specialist Gary W. Gears for AFBN Radio News in Saigon.
AFBN Radio News, on the air 24 hours a day to keep you totally informed.
This is the high-fidelity sound of AFBN-FM, broadcasting from Saigon. Well, that's the music of Mariano and his Unbelievables, Best of Both Worlds. We also included the voices of Peaches and Herbs, So True, and the music of George Shearing, Love is Blue, making up our FM sounds and music on a Sunday morning.
Do you want to?
There's no doubt that Hawaii is the surf and sun capital of the world, a great place for a five-day vacation and a great place to meet your own Honolulu Lulu. So say aloha to the islanders and hello to your R&R officer. He'll arrange for you to...
To Hawaii!
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 Oh, checking the time for you now. It's 14 minutes after 10 o'clock.
Raindrops on roses and whiskers on kittens, bright copper kettles and warm woolen mittens, brown paper packages tied up with strings. These are a few of my favorite things. Cream-colored ponies and crisp apple strudels, doorbells and sleigh bells and schnitzels with noodles, wild geese that fly with the moon on their wings. These are a few of my favorite things. Girls in white dresses with blue satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into spring. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, I simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad. Satin sashes, snowflakes that stay on my nose and eyelashes, silver white winters that melt into spring. These are a few of my favorite things. When the dog bites, when the bee stings, when I'm feeling sad, simply remember my favorite things, and then I don't feel so bad.
Oh, that's the music of the T-Bones on a Sunday morning. The FM sounds and music for you at 19 minutes after 10 o'clock. That was called Shangri-La. We also played Tony Bennett, a new song for Tony called My Favorite Things.
The American Forces Vietnam Network presents The Very Infectious Adventures of Count Malaria. A mess hall near Nha Trang.
Hey, are these mashed potatoes lumpy or what?
Good evening.
What are you doing in my mashed potatoes?
The Australian crawl, but that is of no importance. Do you take a chloroquine and primaquine phosphate tablet once a week?
Malaria pills? Never touch them myself.
Wonderful.
You bit me.
How very observant of you.
Who is that?
I'm not sure, but he just disappeared in my mashed potatoes.
How about that? Yet another unchloroquine serviceman falls victim to the evil count.
He was certainly right.
About the malaria pill?
No, about the mashed potatoes. They are lumpy.
Everyone needs someone to love. I do. You do. Someone the angels up above sent down to comfort and cherish you. Everyone needs someone to love. So let me love you tonight. Please don't be afraid. I'm so certain it's right. Darling, that's why people and they believe me.
Well, the music of Trombones Unlimited, the work song, the voice of Nick Palmer, Everybody Needs Someone to Love, and the T-Bone Shangri-La making up this portion of the Sounds of Music on a Sunday morning on AFVN FM.
$5,328,141.
What are you doing?
Don't bother me. I'm counting the number of seconds I have left in my tour in Vietnam.
Are you anxious to see your tour in the service end?
No, I'm counting the number of hairs on the hippies in San Francisco. 5,328,000.
How'd you like to leave the service 5 months early? You can, you know, simply by extending your tour in Vietnam. You extend to ensure that you have less than 150 days remaining in service. And then when you go back to the States, you'll be given an early out and credit for full active service.
5,328,000. What did you say?
Go see your unit personnel officer for full details. You can get out of the service 5 months early.
5 months early, hmm? Let's see, what would it take? Subtract the square root of my zip code divided by the humidity.
Army Specialist Mike Halloran bringing you the Sunday morning sounds in FM listening, 25 minutes after 10 o'clock.
Again, no, no, again.
Well, that's the guitar stylings of Santo and Johnny on this Sunday morning. And She's a Rainbow. You also heard the voice of Timi Euro, and I'll Never Fall in Love. The time is 10:30. I'd like to thank you for some of the telephone calls this morning, complimenting us on our FM programming. But we don't take requests. Most of our music is pre-programmed.
Are you going on R&R soon? Want to know a surefire way of being delayed, either going or once you get to your destination? Well, it's not having your shunt record with you. It's important, to say the least. So always have it with you, no matter where you're going. R&R days are too precious to lose valuable time waiting for officials to figure out what to do with you now that they know the old shunt record has been forgotten or lost.
Oh, checking the time for you now. It's 10:31 on this Sunday morning.
I can't help it if I'm still in love with you. Today I passed you on the street, and my heart fell at your feet. I can't help it if I'm still in love with you. Somebody else stood by your side, and he looked so satisfied. I can't help it if I'm still in love with you. I brushed your arm and walked so close to you. Then suddenly I got that old time feeling. I can't help it if I'm still in love with you.
Today I passed you on the street,
and my heart fell at your feet.
I can't help it if I'm still in love with you. Somebody has stood by your side,
and he looked so satisfied.
I can't help it if I...
69 sounds of Mr. Peter Duchin. He will break your hearts. And the voice of Al Martino, I Can't Help It If I'm Still in Love with You, making up this portion of our FM sounds and music for you on a Sunday morning.
Are you going on R&R soon? Want to know a surefire way of being delayed, either going or once you get to your destination? Well, it's not having your shunt record with you. It's important, to say the least. So always have it with you, no matter where you're going. R&R days are too precious to lose valuable time waiting for officials to figure out what to do with you now that they know the old shunt record has been forgotten or lost.
Well, your dial is set at 99.9 megacycles. You're listening to the FM Sounds and Music coming to you from Saigon.
The county, and I drive the main road, searching in the sun for another overload. I hear you singing in the wire, I can hear you through the tall lineman is still on the line. I know I need a small vacation, but it don't look like rain. And if it snows, that stretch down south won't ever. I need you more than want you, and I want you for all time, and the Wichita line.